Maths Department, B.S. Abdul Rahman Institute of Science and Technology. The topic I've chosen for today is Kutl-McKee algorithm. Before going into the topic, I would like to introduce about where and when we apply this algorithm. Starting with the linear system of equations, we come across system of equations Ax is equal to b, and suppose if A matrix is a sparse symmetric matrix, then solving these equations are really challenging task. In that case, we have to take an inverse of A matrix so that we can get the solution of the linear equations. So in this case, since the A matrix is a huge sparse symmetric matrix, we cannot solve it directly, and we convert it into a graph, and then we reduce the bandwidth of the graph. Finally, the resultant graph gives us a banded matrix which would be comfortable to solve. So first of all, we are constructing a graph from some matrix. Let me take a simple finite element matrix here. I have done the numbering. It has totally 16 vertices. From this original graph, we have to apply the algorithm. In brief, let me just give you the steps of performing the Kutl-McKee algorithm. First, we choose a minimum degree vertex. From that vertex, we construct level structure. So the vertices will be split into levels. Later then, according to the levels, we number them with the hierarchy of the degree. Starting from the least degree to a maximum degree, we number them. So how many number of least degree nodes are available in the graph? We have to perform this level structure again and again, and we have to take the minimum numbering graph which gives the minimum bandwidth. So for this particular graph, I am going to construct a level structure. So first I have least degree nodes. The least degree nodes are number 1, 4, 7 and 14 with a degree of 2. So first I am going to choose the vertex 1. So here when I take the vertex as the first level, this vertex lies in the first level. So the vertices which are adjacent to 1 are 2 and 2. Here this vertex is not adjacent, so I should not number them with 2. So this belongs to the second numbering. So here, coming to the second level vertices, the vertices adjacent to this 2 are this vertex and this vertex. So this has to be number 3, and this vertex takes the number 3. Simultaneously, for this vertex 2, the other 2 adjacent vertices are these 2 vertices. So this is not a vertex, I should not number them as 3. So later, going on to the next level, from 3 I have to move to 4. So these 2 are already numbered. So this vertex has adjacent vertex 4, and suppose this is also an adjacent vertex, so it takes the value 4. And for coming to this third vertices, these 2 are adjacent, this is already numbered, so I number it as 4. Finally, this has these 2 vertices as adjacent vertices, so this is already numbered, so I number it as 4 here. Now these 4 vertices has the adjacency vertices as 5, so this becomes 5, and similarly this becomes 5, and this has a vertex which has been already numbered, so we stick to that number. So the vertices adjacent to this 5 are 6 and 6. So finally here, the vertex adjacent to the 6th level will become 7. So totally we have 7 levels, and in level 1 we have 1 vertex, in level 2 we have 2, in level 3 we have 3, and in level 4 we have 4 vertices, in level 5 we have 3 vertices, and level 6 has 2, and level 7 has 1. So this is the total level numbering. Finally, we would be numbering the vertices according to the levels. Initially I started with this vertex, so I am numbering that vertex as 1. Next, the 2 adjacent vertices are chosen here, and which one is the least degree? Both has the degree 3, so arbitrarily I am choosing this vertex as the second and this vertex as the third. From the second level, I am moving on to the third level of vertices and numbering them. So here this vertex and this vertex should be compared. This has 3 and this has 4. So obviously after 3 I start with 4 and 5. Then coming to the third adjacent vertex as 6. So the third level vertices are being numbered. Finally, I'm coming to the fourth level of vertices. I stopped with 6, so I have to start with 7, and the vertex adjacent to 4 will become 8. Next, coming to 5, this vertex is adjacent to 5, so later consecutive number 9 is applied. Finally, for 6 I have 10. So now for 8 I have 11 and 12, for 9 I have 13, finally 14, 15 and 16. The vertices are numbered according to their hierarchy in the degree. Yes, this is one structure. But since my symmetric matrix has been yielded a graph which has all four corners as least degree, all the four vertices are symmetric. So hence this gives you the same bandwidth. So here you can stop your algorithm, since this yields a same bandwidth as the other three vertices, which gives you the bandwidth, the least reduced bandwidth. So this is about Cartle-Mickey algorithm. Thank you.